Thank you. commencement for this seventh Sunday after Pentecost. Please note this week there is no Mass from Monday to Thursday, and on Friday the Mass will be at 7 p.m. only. The reason is Canon and I are both in Italy for the ordination for our institute, since it's a Christ the King, and I like to pray every day for different seminarians who are going to receive on Monday the cassock for 15 of them. More than 40 will receive tonsure mind orders on Tuesday. On Wednesday we will have 8 new deacons and 7 or 9, I can't remember, deacons. And finally on Thursday, 11 new priests for our institute, for you and for the church. Please pray for them, and don't forget also your prayers in those days, the final days of June and the beginning of July. All the priests of the institute were ordained in those days, in the past years, anniversary of priesthood, and pray for them in order they can be holy priests for you and the church. We will have the joy to receive the new young canon Monja, who spent a few months last year here in Preston for a Thanksgiving Mass, a solemn Mass on the Saturday, the 30th of July at 10:30. So we will have a small reception just after. And on the Sunday, 17th of July, Mass here, 10:30 will be said by His Lordship, Bishop of Lancaster. Don't forget that, and please come to welcome the whole bishop for his visit. And finish, we are away from tomorrow morning, but tonight there are still the adoration as every Sunday at 6 p.m. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. You will know them by the fruit they yield. How we can recognize the false prophets? That's the gospel of today. False prophets are those people who are saying to everybody, do what I say, but never do what I do for me. There are plenty of pride, because they are thinking they are superior to everybody. That's a false prophet. False prophets are all those people who are also thinking that the goods are useless to go to heaven. That's the vision of the Protestants. That's the vision of Luther. And that was condemned by the Holy Council of Trent. This Holy Council teaches that goods are necessary to go to heaven. And they remind us that with the goods we need to prayer, fasting, and alms deeds. That are the three ways of what we have to do to go to heaven. They are especially indicated in the Holy Scripture, in the Book of Tobiah. By prayer is here understood all religious services. Prayer is begin with your morning and evening prayer, with the Mass and all the etc. this day can be a good day. At the end of every day, you have to ask yourself if this day was good or not. And a good way to know that is to think, did I offer all my actions? Did I pray before my actions in order to sanctify them? If yes, that's okay. If not, you have to correct it. By fasting, the second point, will understand all the mortification of soul and body. Mortification of soul is the mortification most of all of our imagination in order to control our patience, to control our imagination and to forget all the occasions of sin. But the body is most of the time we think about the past, but it's also some things, some mortification we will do in order to offer a sacrifice to God. This mortification of the body is more today than before, is forgot by many, many people. Because we are in a world, we don't want the sufferings. But that's not the way our Lord showed us how to go to bed. The Lord suffered a Pentecost for us. And this suffering wasn't only spiritual with all our sins he saw when he was on the Pentecost. That was also corporal suffering. And which with this model we have to take the example from the Lord and to accept all the mortifications he sent us in order to test. And remember, if he sends us sufferings in our body, he sends us also the grace to support them. As he sends us the grace to support and to be victorious against the temptation. And finally, the third good is the arms, deeds. And that's it, all works of charity. The work of charity, perhaps, virtues with many, many times for us. But there is some way the Church teaches how to complete this work of charity. There's two kinds, corporal and spiritual. Each kind has seven different goods. The spiritual works of mercy, they are performed for the good of the soul, and that's the admonition of the sinners, teaching the ignorant, to counsel the doubtful, to counsel the afflicted, to settle injustice passionately, to forgive all injuries, and to pray for the living and the dead. That are the spiritual works of mercy. And the corporal works, they are performed for the good of the body. And they are to feed the hungry, to give drink to the thirsty, to clothe the naked, to visit and ransom the captives, to harbor the harborless, visit the sick and to raise them. When we heard all these 14 different words of mercy, we have to make spiritual works first. because all people can do that. Spiritual works are very, very important. And they are the first that all people can do. For example, to teach ignorance. In order to teach the ignorance, you have to know the faith. If you ignorance yourself, you make a sin against God first and against the charity, because you are unable to teach the ignorance. If you ignorance yourself, that's an example. You have to learn the faith, that's very important. You have to learn in order to teach. That's a transmission. Can we be saved without good works? And no. For Christ expressed, he says, every tree that bringeth no forth good fruit shall be cut down and shall be cast into the fire. The servant in the gospel who did not even waste the talent received, but only hid it in the ground, while therefore cast into hearts of darkness. How greatly do those err who hope to reach heaven simply because they do not have it. Of this great mistake, St. John Chrysostom plainly says, if you have a servant who was no true, no robber, no glutton or drunkard, but who sat at home ill, neglecting everything from which you had employed him, would you not pay him with the whip and send him off? Is it not bad enough to neglect that which duty demands? Such a servant is a Christian also. Such a servant, sorry, is a Christian who, doing neither good or evil, makes himself thereby unfit for heaven, which is a reward of work faithful. And if no work has been done, no reward is to be expected. That not only as the Lord says in the Gospel of today, not only with the prayer, not the only man who is saying, O Lord, Lord, Master, Master, we are going to heaven. Only the man that does the will of my Father, who is in heaven, are those men. Finally, we can take the example of the Blessed Virgin Mary, who spent all his living life to the prayer and good works. And the first good works she made was to accept to be Mother of Christ. And as she was Mother of Christ, spent all her life around, she organized all her life around this great mystery of the redemption. She was at the bottom of the cross, offering his proper sufferings, while his only son was suffering for us. As St. Paul said in his epistle, we have to complete what is missing. The passion of the Christ in our body. What is missing is our participation as for you to the passion of the Christ, accepting what the Christ sent us, and offering in order to unite to this passion. That's how we are going to heaven, how we are going to sing forever and ever the joy in the life of everlasting. Amen. The name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you.
Darkness.